ready for the bass. My DJ, yo, get on the case. Who's that? Get down. Who's in the mic with a wickedest sound? Wickedest sound. Wickedest sound. Cześć, tu Tauczyn i witam Was w kolejnym odcinku LCS News. Nie może to jest połączone takie trochę z zaległym, bo akurat wtedy nie miałem czasu, żeby nagrać pomiędzy dwoma dniami, to znaczy po czwartkowych meczach nie mogłem nagrać w piątek, więc nie wiem, czy w ten będę mógł, chyba zobaczymy. Ostatecznie nagrywam no jakby dwa odcinki w jednym, czyli to jest cały tydzień szósty, a wyniki no to będą się liczyły tylko te, bo tutaj tych głosów nie było oddanych, więc mamy 35-23, bo trafiłem 2 i nie trafiłem 2, to znaczy, że trafiłem Rocka, które grały z Gambit in Pyjamas, bo były zmiany w Gambicie przez to, że zawodnicy Gambitu musieli załatwić sobie wizy. Wszyscy oprócz Edwarda, znaczy nie wszyscy, bo Genża nie musiał, ale ze względu na fakt, że jego angielski jest bardzo kiepski, postanowił nie zostać. No i pierwszy mecz tutaj głosowałem na Millennium i wygrał Copenhagen Wolves, chociaż no Kreaton jak zwykle starał się kierować swój team 3-0-1, ale nie podobał, 600 farmy ponad wywalił, ale za to Forgiven tutaj pobił rekord w tym meczu, 658 i 703 Lucianem, bardzo ładna gra, praktycznie bez skazy. Następne to właśnie było Gambit in Pyjamas. Dlaczego in Pyjamas? No bo ci rezerwowi gracze to głównie skład Ninjas in Pyjamas, a przede wszystkim Nuke Dog i Zara Zero, czyli top lane Ninjas in Pyjamas i mid lane. No ale ten mecz zakończył się zwycięstwem Rockcat i od niego dostanie się skrót na koniec. Później był mecz Super Hot Crew z Fnaticiem, w którym po raz kolejny Fnatic poległ i to była ich szósta przegrana z rzędu. Mieli najpierw 7 wygranych z rzędu, teraz to była ich szósta przegrana. I mimo tego, że ten mecz już był naprawdę bliski zwycięstwa Fnaticu, jednak zabrakło. I co jest dziwne, co nie jest dziwne, ale co jest takie podbudowujące, Rekkles cały czas gra bardzo dobrze, ale niestety to nie starcza. No i ostatnie to było SK Gaming kontra Alliance i cały czas, mimo tego, że stracili inhibitor na bocie, oglądałem ten mecz bardzo dokładnie, tam mimo, że stracili inhibitor na bocie, mimo, że SK strasznie ścisnęła, potem nagle teamfighty, jeden, drugi, trzeci, zdołali wszystko obrócić na swoją korzyść i wygrać ten mecz w zwycięskim dla nich tygodniu. Później był następny dzień, piątek, w którym niestety nie miałem czasu, widziałem tylko mecz Fnatic z Copenhagen Wolves, który Fnatic po raz kolejny przegrało. Siódmy mecz z rzędu i mieli 7 wygranych i 7 przegranych z rzędu. Tutaj nie było dyskusji, naprawdę dostali strasznie. Jedynie Rekkles jako jedyny miał jakieś kile i żadnych deadów znowu. Tutaj przewaga Copenhagen Wolves i jest 7-7 w Fnaticu. Później Gambit Gaming, Gambit in Pyjamas. Tu już tego meczu nie widziałem. Grali z Super Hot Crew, jak widzimy, wygrali. No i Rockcat ze SK Gaming niestety przegrał, chociaż jak tak patrzeć, tych kili naprawdę jest minimalna ilość. Tutaj było 2, 4, 5, 6, 8 po stronie SK Gaming i 3 po stronie Rockcat, więc 3 do 8, bardzo mały rezultat w killach, no ale widocznie SK była lepsza. No i Millennium kontra Alliance. Wygrana tym razem Millennium, mimo że to był zwycięski tydzień Alliance. No więc w sumie trochę dobrze, że ten mecz się nie trafił w ten Po prostu głosował na Fnatic, na Gambit tu bym akurat trafił, na Rocket i na Alliance, więc dobrze, że nie było tego, bym Czech na pewno nie trafił. No i to jest to, spójrzmy w tym momencie na tabelę. W tym momencie Rocket pierwsze miejsce, 10-4. Gambit drugie, nawet po tygodniu, kiedy mieli zmiany, jeden mecz zmiany zdołały wygrać. 9-5. SK razem z Superhot Crew i z Fnaticiem 7-7 na trzecim miejscu. Dalej szóste miejsce Copenhagen Wolves 6-8 i siódme Exequo Alliance i Millennium. Dobrze, więc zagłosujmy. To właściwie już tutaj możemy, bo to będzie 27, czyli za 2 dni w czwartek, mecze. To będzie tak: Alliance kontra Fnatic. I teraz jest pytanie: czy Alliance, którzy mają no strasznie, strasznie różne mecze, jeżeli chodzi, no raz wygrane, raz przegrane, raz wygrane, raz przegrane, zdoła pokonać Fnatic, które miało 7 wygranych pod rząd, a potem 7 przegranych pod rząd? Ciężko mi naprawdę określić, ale zważywszy na strasznie złą passę Fnaticu, zagłosuję tym razem na Alliance. Dalej SK Gaming kontra Superhot Crew. I to jest kolejne dwie drużyny, które raz mają dobry mecz, raz mają zły. Ostatnio jednak wygrali z SK wygrała z Superhot Crew, a Superhot Crew przegrało z Gambitem in Pyjamas, więc ja bym tutaj był za SK. Dalej jest Millennium kontra Gambit. Wracają, chyba, wydaje mi się, już starzy zawodnicy. I tutaj zagłosuję na Gambit i Rocket kontra Copenhagen Wolves. Trzeci mecz. Oni muszą to wygrać. Ja nie widzę innego wyjścia. To już przede wszystkim. Tak, i to jest na czwartek. No i postaram się w piątek. Mam nadzieję, że dam radę. Postaram się to nagrać, omówienie tego i wrzucić wam głosowanie na piątek. A to tyle, jeżeli chodzi o ten odcinek LCS News. I ja was zapraszam na obejrzenie skrótu meczu Rocket vs Gambit in Pyjamas.
The one thing I do want to remind everybody about Overpowered Ziggs in particular, he was the first person that built that Spirit of the Spectral Wraith. He's going to get his first taste of Invade right now as Holberto is going to be sandwiched. Blue, but the red goes to Holberto.
Holberto gets it, but it's a 3-on-1. Wow, big power damage straight away onto him. No problem there for Overpower. Quick first blood.
Nuke Duck, just the use of that Ignite. Vander, can he connect with the Dark Binding? No, he cannot. Jankers is going to be forced to back away. That minion, very unhappy with his damage right now.
Flash ulti coming out there is not going to pull off though. Instead, they're all going to back away. He's going to try and go in. Jankos could not get the other side of Edward there, quickly using that wild growth to keep him away.
So one flash kick. They've got Edward now.
Oh, Dark Binding this time didn't land, but they're kicked in, and Edward's going to get taken low. One more shot should do it. Seliver takes the kill.
Very well played. Edward should not have gone in that quickly. I think he wasn't anticipating the re-engage from members of Rocket and from Gambit. Now, all of a sudden, Holberto's moving to the top lane. They want to dive Zazus.
Zora taking very low, though. He can't tank this one out. That's going to be a Mega Inferno bomb coming in. He just dodges out of it. Doesn't quite get the shot. The tower's not landing on him. Holberto quickly held away and tanked that one out. Very nicely combined by Gambit.
And that is how you punish a Trundle in lane. With a challenge for this one, another objective for Gambit. His advantage. What we have seen from Rocket, though, is a clear focus on dealing with this Edward and Fury lane. They finally grab themselves and even as to play out these next few minutes.
Well, pick wards were picked up by Rocket. There's one being used. Gambit trying to clear this one out, but Rocket want to fight it. Teleport coming in on towards the Death Wish, but Ward, you can see Nuke getting caught out. Satchel charge. Nuke going to get taken down. Now they go in straight on towards it. Dragon still yet to go down. Jankos will secure that one. Zora Zero having to flash away from this one, and now it's going to be Holberto focused on Darkbinding. Will not catch up.
They didn't have the numbers tightly knit, and of course Nuketuck was caught out. Now Vander is in trouble.
Well, is he? That's the question. Well, growth does go down. Vander's stun will proc off in a moment. It's going to be a Fury that goes down, and now Edward's in trouble. He's up against an AD carry. This time he's not playing as Kennen.
Oh!
Eddie, you sneaky little bugger, flashes through, throws down that Ignite, and gets himself the kill on Vander.
He really hasn't made an impact. You see no death marks, you see no fights. He's even on farm, which is great. And now Zazus in a little bit of trouble.
Now Zazus is going to get focused on. He's going to have a spider and a dragon on his backside. He has got Subjugate already used. He's going to try and run away from this one, but he's going to get taken so low. He's not gone down yet and gets away. Would you believe it?
Zazu realizes that Deathmark's not a big threat for him. He's challenging Nuketuck.
He's going back in once again. He's got the Subjugate available. Pops it down. Is it going to be enough? Zazu's taken very low. This could be Nuketuck's first kill. Ignite running. It should be. And Nuketuck takes it down. What advantage was gained from Rockat? I'm not sure, because Zoro is closing in and Rockat in the mid lane.
Yes, so Gambit are aware of it, but they know that Zoro's not there, and Overpass just running interference. Nuketuck is going to have to go in very quickly. Baron's down to less than half.
Alberto's got to run in, but he's been caught out by Dark Binding. He's going to go down. There's nothing he can do about it. That is the jungler gone, and this is desperate, desperate times for Gambit. They could be losing out on this Baron. I don't see anything they can do about it. Rockat secure it.
And that's the power of the Morgana. As long as that Dark Binding does...
So they don't even need it. They're just going to take the inhibitor turret down on the road. They're going to catch on towards Edwin. He just gets destroyed where he stands. And that's an inhibitor picked up by Rockat.
Rockat just brute forced their way. Now Fury's in a little bit of trouble. They've caught Alberto.
Alberto's dead. He's going down. Jankos comes in. Big kick to the face. Finishes that one off. And Sulliver, well, he's just a wrecking crew right now. Down the bottom line, we do see Zazas going down. But to what effect? Who cares? Nuke, you've got a kill. Great. But the rest of your team, you're losing the base. There's the Ohm Wrecker. They're going to finish it off. Sorry, Zero comes around. They're trying to buy some time on there, but they just walk away.
That was a very good satchel charge. Powers away, and they've only just got vision on Zazas. Now Vander's going to be dead.
Vander's dead, or is he? They're going to go in for him. They're going to throw everything at him, but they could turn his back around on towards Nuketuck. He tries to go in. Alberto goes aggressive. Jankos is in a hole, catching, just glancing off his backside. Eddie Keith eating some mines there. But really, what do they get from it? One support.
Yeah, at this point in time, Gambit needs to do that a bunch more. They need to get way more of those kills. And look at that damage from the bouncing bomb. That is so much burst.
Mega Inferno bomb. Well, Kulding not quite landing on towards Fury there. He's just going to be wishing he could. But instead, the teleport comes in. They're going to come around the side. And here's Zazas that climbs in towards it. They catch on towards Nuketuck. Is it going to be enough? Double kill picked up by Overpower. Sorry, Zero tries to go aggressive, trying to catch on towards them. And as it is, will he be going down? He's going to go towards Sullivan. Can he get the kill? The shield comes out. The barrier bait. He does not get the kill. The regen from the Baron buff, which just wore off about 2 minutes ago, actually. Until a lot, it was just locked.
Members of Rockat, the rest of the team, they're on the Nexus turret, and Nuketuck is going to go down shortly.
And Rockat will take themselves another victory, ladies and gentlemen. It's now 5 games on the trot as they take down Gambit in pyjamas once again. And they really have separated themselves.
Wanted in team fights, but they decided they didn't need to. They sieged the mid lane multiple times. They forced Nuketuck to respond to the split pushing of Zazas. And Nuketuck did well in dealing with Zazas, but that didn't necessarily...